LMMS is a great free DAW. In this LMMS tutorial, I'm going to go over how to use the LMMS effects mixer. So if you want to create great music and great beats in this free DAW, keep watching. Welcome to Simple Green Tech. I'm Radio Zane, and on this channel, I do audio tech tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you unleash your creativity. Now today, I'm doing a follow-up video to my LMMS Getting Started tutorial / review, and today we're looking at how to use the LMMS effects mixer. I have a few instruments loaded into LMMS with some basic MIDI information on each instrument. But as you can see, when I click the effects mixer button, I don't have anything routed to the mixer yet. There are a couple of ways we can set this up. And the easiest way is to go to the song editor and click on the gear icon beside the instrument that you want to route to a mixer channel. Then click where it says FX 0 Master, and then click on Assign to New Effects Channel. And you'll see that this has now created a new effects channel named after that instrument. One tip that I'll give you is if you don't want to constantly have to go up and click on the button for the mixer so you can see it, just click on this mixer icon right here in the corner of the mixer window, and then click on Stay on Top. And now if you click out of it, it's going to stay on top. And what I like to do is bring it down to the bottom of the screen, and then I stretch it out right across. And this is how I have it set up in FL Studio as well. Now, if you want to change this track name, we could call it Synth or whatever we want to call this track. I'm going to leave it as Synth because I believe that is sort of a synth track right there. You could do this for each track that you want to assign to a mixer channel. Now, that's one way that you can do it. I'll show you the other way that we can do it. So I'm going to get rid of these channels here. So first we're going to create a channel in here by clicking the plus sign. And now we have a FX1 channel. Now we'll click over here onto the instrument that we want to add to that channel. And we'll bring up the user interface here. And you can either go into where it says FX0, you can click and drag it up until it's at the channel you want, or you can right click there and then assign to FX1. And now it's assigned to FX1 there. And we'll rename that to, that's our bass track. So I'll just call that bass. And I'm going to add our synth again. And then I'll add our drum kit. All right, so let's see what that looks like with everything routed to a channel. So now that you have your instruments routed to the effects mixer, you can easily adjust the levels using the faders on each channel strip. You can also click on these LED lights to either mute or solo a track. So let's listen back here. And we have the bass muted. And then I'll click here. And that's how you solo it. You'll also see that there's a send button at the top here. I'm going to get into that in just a little bit, but first I want to show you how to add effects to each channel. So click on the channel that you want to add an effect to. So I'll click on drums, and then you go over here to where it says effects chain, click on the little LED button there. Now click on add effect, and then you'll just choose your effect from the list here. And you can add several effects to this channel if you want. You can keep adding them and adding them and adding them all you like. And if you close down the user interface and you want to get it back up, you would just click on the controls button right there. And that brings the user interface back up. And if you want to audition how it sounds with and without the effect, you can play it back. And click the little LED button right here to turn it off and back on. Now I'll quickly go over sends. And for this, I'm going to create a new mixer channel. And I'm going to name this bus. Now, I'll click on the channel that I want to route to that. So let's say I want to route the synth to that. Click there, and then I click send on the bus channel. And you'll now see this control here, which controls the amount of the synth channel that I want to send to this bus. And you can add more than one channel to be routed to the same bus. So let's route this one to there as well. And if you want to control the level of each individual track that's sent there, you would just click on the synth one, use this control, and then click on your other one, and you'd use the control that way. And to remove a send from a channel, you would just click on the one that you want to remove. So let's say we want to remove the bass. And then we would click on the green send button and make sure it's white, and that's removed the send from there. You can also route buses to other buses, or you can route a single channel to multiple buses. So it doesn't just have to send to one, you can send it to multiple buses if you really want to. Also, don't forget you can add effects to the master channel over here. So when you're mastering and doing your final mixing, you want to set those up with your EQs and your compression and whatever else you use for your mastering. And this should give you an idea of how to use the effects mixer in LMMS. Click up here to see my LMMS tutorial playlist, or click down here to see what YouTube recommends you watch next. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe if you want to see more videos from me. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Radio Zane, and we'll talk soon.